What's up, comic book junkies? Welcome to another Nighttiger comics video again. Yes, yes. I went to Webster once again.
Watch Nighttiger comics.
Holiday. The biggest I've seen it since 3 years ago. I did find other comic books that were going to be in another video, and Golden Age and Keys. But in this video, I bought a milk crate of comics for $20. The guy wouldn't come down. We tried everything we could to get him to 15. He wouldn't budge. This is a really, really jerky guy. It was really weird. He was like an actor that was being rude, and it was entertaining to hear the things he was saying, even though they weren't nice. It's weird. Anyways, what did I get? I think I got the full run of the Superman Death and Resurrection. So starting with 497 Avenger Doomsday, you guys tell me. I'm not that familiar with this. Shout out to Super Ross. This is one of his favorite storylines. I think that's second Doomsday. I think this is the third Doomsday. I don't know. This may be a good opportunity for me to finally read the whole run, the whole storyline. There actually were cards in there. And then this one is one I'm keeping because it's a newsstand, but it's the Doomsday, I don't know, close-up cover. The issue before Superman's killed. I should read it, right? And then you got the Black 75 Death of Superman with the fold-out splash black cover, full poster, commemorative stamps, Daily Planet obituary, Black Morning armband, exclusive Skybox trading card. This one was signed by Doug Hazelwood. Came with a COA right there. Rob Meyer. These came out to like 23 cents, something like that. Then you had another one. And you had another one. Somebody was investing. $1 million. Then you got, so that's the death. Then you got the funeral. Two. Three, part three. Part four. The only one I could see that was missing out of this was part five. So that's not here. So part six. And these are all mid to upper grade. These are all mid to upper grades. These are the average is probably like a is like 885s, 90s. And then that's number seven. Here's number eight. So he's going to heaven. He's dead. And then there's the resurrection of the four super peoples. First appearance of Steel's in here. I remember I practiced, this is one of the first books I practiced pressing on, and I forgot there was glue in here. And I came back to the press, and glue was just oozing out the spine. And then, yes, then you got 500, you got the whatever holographic cover, but this one is also signed by Doug Hazelwood. So the third SIG book I found this week for under $2. Then you got the gold foil, whatever that is, the Reign of Superman, and some more silver foil. Two of those. I don't know if one's a second print or not. And then you have the new Superboy. Whatever that, I forgot that guy's name. You got Steel and that guy, I forget his name. This one right here. And then, is Superman back? Is that him? We don't know. So you got Superman's fighting Superman's. The Eradicator. No, is that him? Yeah, that's the Eradicator right there. That I did like him the most, I think, out of the four. I thought he was like the Wolverine of the Superman. Then you got more Superman and more and more and more. We're almost done. But I'm telling you, we got the whole storyline. Incredible, huh? Two of these. Bada bing, bada boom. I think I have a bunch of these. The die cuts. Bonus super posters inside. Man, the 90s, man. And you got this one here. It has a bonus something in it. Last Son of Krypton poster. Holy crap. Who had superhero posters on their room when they were a kid? I did. I had X-Men. I bought like a set of X-Men prints that were blown up. These were there. I'm keeping one of these. One of these is, this one here is got a little bit of a tiny ding. This is the Wizard Superman Special Tribute Edition. Here's a really nice minty one that's going in my collection. And so that was it for the Superman, the death, resurrection, and all that. That may be a prize. I don't know if anybody's even interested in that anymore. Okay, so we had some image books. We have Max number one. This is actually a really, really, really nice copy for this black cover. It's like a nine. This is a 9.8 candidate, I say. I may keep it. Such high grade. Matter of fact, I think I will. I already have a high grade of this. I already have a 9.8 candidate. But Savage Dragon. I think this is volume one. You got Freak Force on the back. Then we have Max number three. And Max number four. I noticed that he signed his name similar to Bruner. Oh, so Max number two is on the back. And then we have Wildcats 1. I had a dime for every time that thing came through my door and right back out. Wildcats number 2, gold foil. So that's going to somebody. Wildcats number 5, Jim Lee, of course. Wildcats 6. Savage Dragon 3. Did I just already pull that out of here? Oh, that was... It's getting better. It's getting better. Wildcats Trilogy. Shiny cover. Morbius number 2. Some random issues. What the heck? And then we got some Spawn. Early Spawn number 10. These are spoken for already. These are probably 9.6. 9.4s to 9.6s. Spawn number whatever's. So somebody... A newer viewer, a new junkie, contacted me on Instagram and said that I want to sell these early spawns because I had showed them on the Instagram post. And I said, send me your address, and if you can wait till February, I'll send them to you for free. And I have more, and I'll throw them in there. And some NyQuest. It's getting better, people. A Wizard Max half, a really nice copy of that. I'm going to keep that. And that has a Max number 4 in the bag. So that I'm going to keep. Then we got two issues of Bronze Age Iron Man. Return of the Hero. And this 97. I'll probably give these to the grandson. And then the whole miniseries was in here. Of Iceman number 4. This is like a 9.8 right here. Number 3, First Oblivion. So people were banking on he was going to be big. Number 2. So those last two are like 9.8s. The first two are like 8.5, 9.0s. So those are spoken for. Another YouTuber friend of mine asked me what my plans were for these, and I said, you can have them. He's actually going to send me a Thor price variant for the Bronze Age, 35 center. So that's going to go to him. Okay, so then there was this is my second only No, I'm sorry. My second Spawn newsprint that I've ever found, and my third image from the 90s newsprint I've ever found. These things are extremely, really hard to find. They're a lot harder than the DCU logos. That's number 15. That's staying in the collection. You can see that's bagged and board already. I ran out of bags and boards, man. The supply around here is next to zero. And so I have to order them off eBay. And hopefully they'll be here tomorrow. So, okay, the big books for me were the next one. I don't have this one. Matter of fact, I don't have any of the four of the first miniseries. So I was happy to find this nice 8590 copy of Wolverine number 3. From November 82, Frank Miller on Story and Art. Nice black cover. I mean, it's not a perfect copy, but it's really nice for a black cover. So that's going to my collection. And then I got the whole series. This was all in there. This is why I paid the $20. Now, the funny thing is, my grandson's been begging me to get this for him. And he asked if I could get him this series. So it's funny that both these series ended up in this crate. It was really weird. So number 6, Starlin Perez, Infinity Gauntlet number 6 from December 1991. Of course, the Avengers Endgame was based on this. Number 5. Now these are 9.2 copies. Some of them have like a little dark, very light, but you could tell it's like a little bit of dirt or something. I need to clean them. Number 4, unless someone handled them there with a dirty finger or something, I don't know. Now, I was missing actually issues 3 and 4 to complete my own run. The rest of these are going to go to the grandson. And we have number 3. And I only read issue 1, so now I can finally read the rest of the miniseries. Number 2. And last but not least, the big book out of the whole crate. Infinity Gauntlet number 1. Now, this book has come down a lot. You can get a 9.8 raw copy for somewhere between 30, 40 bucks. Maybe even less. This is the third one that I pulled out of that flea market for under $3. So this book alone would pay for the whole thing. Probably two of these may pay for. So this book alone would pay for the whole thing. This book alone would definitely pay for the whole thing. So I more than made my money back. With these two books and the two I was missing out of this series, I think I did pretty well. And tell me what you think in the comments. Stay tuned. I got the flea market haul coming up. I got books coming in the mail. I got 3 packages back here need to be opened. I actually have books that, like a stack like this, Golden Age, Silver Age, I haven't done a haul on yet. So I'm getting packed up already. It's 2003. I have to say 2022 was an awesome year for collecting. Anyways, don't want to waste your time any longer. Turn this off. Go to the next video. Nighttiger out.